Hello everyone. Following our previous session, today, we'll delve into the integral test for infinite series. According to the integral test, if a function f is continuous, decreasing, and positive for x is greater than or equal to 1, and a sub n is f of n, then the infinite series a sub n and the integral of f of x from 1 to infinity either both converge or diverge. Seems a bit complicated, doesn't it? Let me simplify and get straight to the point. If the integral of f of x from 1 to infinity converges, then the infinite series a sub n also converges. On the other hand, if the integral of f of x diverges, then infinite series a sub n will also diverge. Now, let's visually demonstrate the integral test. Here, an arbitrary function f of x is represented in green. To calculate the right Riemann sum from 1 to infinity, we draw rectangles with a width of 1 each, shown in orange. The precise area under the curve of the function f of x from 1 to infinity is marked in red. Comparing this red continuous area with the right Riemann sum, we can observe that the continuous area is greater than or equal to the sum of the rectangles. Now, let's examine the left Riemann sum. All the rectangles have a width of 1, represented in blue. The infinite sum of these blue rectangles is greater than or equal to the red area under the graph on the left. Let's summarize what we discussed so far. The area of the orange rectangles on the left is the sum of the a sub n as n goes from 2 to infinity, representing the right Riemann sum. Since the first rectangle's height is a sub 2 instead of a sub 1, n starts from 2. The red area under the curve in the middle is the integral of f of x from 1 to infinity. Finally, the blue rectangles on the right are the left Riemann sum, representing the sum of a sub n from 1 to infinity. Through these three figures, we can establish the following inequality relationships. Now, let's make one assumption. If the infinity integral in the middle converges to some real value, let's call it L, what would happen to the left infinite series? The infinite series on the left cannot exceed the value of L. Therefore, if the infinite integral converges a certain value, say L, the left infinite series must also converge. Now, let's consider the opposite scenario. Suppose the integral from 1 to infinity of f of x diverges to infinity. In this case, from the perspective of the right infinite series, values that were smaller than itself become infinite. Consequently, the right infinite series must also diverge to infinity. This is how, in the integral test, the fate of the infinite integral and the infinite series becomes intertwined. Let's summarize the content so far. If f is continuous, decreasing, and positive for x is greater than or equal to 1, and a sub n is f of n, then the sum of a sub n from 1 to infinity and the integral of f of x from 1 to infinity either both converge or both diverge. When using the integral test, there are two important points to be aware of. The first is that f of x must be continuous, decreasing, and positive. As a mnemonic, I personally memorize it as CDP, inspired by the letters in the CD player. If these conditions are not met, be cautious as the integral test cannot be applied. The second point is that even if the infinite integral converges to a certain value L, it doesn't necessarily mean that the infinite series will also converge to the same L value. In general, these two values are different, so use the integral test primarily for determining convergence or divergence. Let's delve into examples to understand this better. The first example is the infinite sum of 2n over n squared plus 1. Let's denote f of x as 2x over x squared plus 1. For x greater than or equals to 1, f of x remains continuous since the denominator never becomes 0. Additionally, as the degree of the denominator is greater than that of the numerator, f of x decreases as x increases, and it always takes positive values. Now, let's integrate to apply the integral test. The integral of 2x over x squared plus 1 from 1 to infinity involves improper integration, so let's express it using limits. As the limit of b goes to infinity, we can write the integral from 1 to b of 2x over x squared plus 1. The integral of box prime over box is explained to be ln modulus box plus c in another video, and you can find the link to that video in the top right corner. When integrating a fraction where the derivative of the denominator appears in the numerator, the result is ln modulus denominator. applying this to our integral, the result is ln modulus x squared plus 1. Evaluating the integral from 1 to b and taking the limit as b approaches to infinity gives us the limit of ln b squared plus 1 minus ln 2. If we simplify the expression further, it becomes the limit of ln b squared plus 1 over 2 as b approaches to infinity, and ultimately, the value becomes infinity. Since the result of the improper integral diverges to infinity, our companion in destiny, the infinite series 2n over n squared plus 1, will also diverge. This time, let's consider the infinite sum of 1 over n squared plus 1. If we set f of x as 1 over x squared plus 1, it seems like a shape that is suitable for integration. Before proceeding, let's check if it satisfies the CDP conditions for the x is greater than or equal to 1. Since the denominator doesn't become 0, it is continuous. Also, as the denominator's degree is greater than the numerator's, it is always decreasing. Finally, all terms are always positive. Hence, it satisfies the other conditions and we can use the integral test. Then, for the improper integration of 1 over x squared plus 1, using the limit, we get the limit of the integral of 1 over x squared plus 1 from 1 to b as b approaches infinity. The integral of 1 over x squared plus 1 is the inverse tangent, so we can write it as the limit of arctangent as b approaches infinity. Substituting b and 1, we get the limit of arctangent b minus arctangent 1, and as b approaches infinity, this value becomes pi over 2 minus pi over 4, ultimately resulting in pi over 4. Since the integral test yields a final value, the sum of 1 over n squared plus 1 as n goes from 1 to infinity also converges. Now let's examine the convergence or divergence of the sum of 1 over n times square root ln n as n goes from 2 to infinity. First, let's set f of x as 1 over x times square root ln x, and for easier integration, we write this expression as ln x to the power of negative half times 1 over x. Now, let's consider the CDP conditions. For x greater than or equal to 2, this function is always continuous, decreasing, and all terms are positive. Having satisfied all the conditions, let's proceed with the integration. The integral of ln x to the power of negative half times 1 over x from 2 to infinity can be expressed using the limit as the limit of the integral of ln x to the power of negative half times 1 over x from 2 to b, where b goes to infinity. For the sake of easy integration, let's use the box rule as explained in another video. Please refer to the link in the top right corner for more details. The integral of box to the power of n multiplied by the derivative of box, box prime, simplifies to box to the power of n plus 1 over n plus 1 plus c. Comparing this with our problem, we see that box involves ln x, n becomes negative half, and the subsequent box prime includes 1 over x. The expression on the right follows the same pattern, with the box containing ln x and n being negative half. Thus, the limit of ln x to the power of half over half is obtained. Simplifying further, we get the limit of 2 times ln x to the power of half. Substituting b and 2, we end up with the limit of 2 square root ln b minus 2 square root ln 2 as b approaches to infinity. The result of this expression eventually diverges to infinity. Since the integral result diverges, the sum of 1 over n times square root ln n as n goes from 2 to infinity also diverges. In today's lesson on the integral test, please make sure to check the three conditions CDP, which are essential for using the integral test. Only apply the test when the given function satisfies these conditions. Do not forget the fact that infinite series and infinite integration share a common destiny of convergence and divergence. That concludes today's video prepared for you. In the next video, we'll continue exploring various testing methods for infinite series. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing and giving it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching. This has been your Math Guardian, Alex.